The huge growth in mobile money wallets has boosted the country's drive towards greater financial inclusion. But subscribers have not been able to keep up with the technology, thereby making them prey to fraudsters. Now, the operators have been charged to do more to protect the users of the platform. Alfredo Kante has the rest of the story.
Has been overwhelming after the Bank of Ghana replaced the branchless bank guidelines with the electronic money guidelines in 2015. 66.4 billion cedis was recorded in the first quarter of the year, compared to 52.4 billion cedis over the same period last year. Such exponential growth over the past 4 years is attracting sophisticated fraudulent activities. This is typical mobile money fraudsters in a telephone call.
Good afternoon. Hello, and thank you for calling MTN. Our calls are recorded for quality and training purposes. For English, press 1. For Chinese, press 1. For English, press 1.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Madam Pacho, my name is Mr. Anthony Mpacho. We didn't even be able
to advance
Cyber and e-crime analyst Eric Mensah expects wallet holders to keep up with technology.
Criminals are preying on key vulnerabilities within the system. Key amongst them is the lack of security consciousness of subscribers. And you realize that scams is one, counterfeiting.
Some members of the public shared how they're able to identify fraudsters.
Also, Pamicho, now Osani MTN Mobile. 350. I will give me phone so. And to me checking my account to see and I'm see Mati. But me a yeah MTN phone can say Obikasana and check your account at the immediately. And I miss all the scanning manhwaya or see Obi Yari or hospital. And he found see Kolebu. Now Pamitra, no Kasati so be ya. Why Yari? I say oh or Dani or see Kolebu. And I miss your cry or Kolebu Ayakasa. Or see Debbie, or Nicolebu, or Kumansi, and I miss Kumansi Hifa, or see Kumansi Kolebu, and I miss Kumansi Sukolebu.
I think one of them, the voice was from a lady. And then she will call you and she will start speaking a local language with you. And she will be like, she's one of your relatives abroad. So if you actually have a relative abroad, you might think it is true. My sister was once a victim. They actually got sick. I think she sent 500 cedis also.
The telecoms chamber says it is engaging operators and the regulator to identify fraudulent transactions. They also advise the public to be on the lookout.
Some tidbits that we share with customers. The first one being that your mobile money PIN is like the most important thing to you. That's what first and foremost, that's your secret. So you don't share your secret with anyone if you don't want to be exposed in any way or the other. And it's also important to say that the fraudster would require active support or participation to be able to defraud you of your money on the wallet. The second one is you do not entertain calls to discuss your mobile money wallet.
Data from the Payment Systems Department of the Bank of Ghana shows the use of checks as a means of payment declined in the first quarter of 2019.